A new report indicates Hispanics feel less hopeful about their future in America today. The Hispanic Sentiment Study found nearly half of its second-generation respondents believe, quote, the American dream is alive, but it's not what it once was. The study also says an overwhelming majority of Hispanics think they should be valued more than they currently are. The report is being shared at the UN's first-ever Hispanic Leadership Summit today. The nonpartisan event mission is to unify America's largest diverse community. Our colleague, Elaine Quiano, spoke to Claudia Romo Edelman yesterday. Edelman is the founder of the We Are All Human Foundation, which commissioned the survey.
A lot of interesting findings here, and I want to start with this. The study found the U.S. Hispanic community feels underappreciated. About two-thirds of those surveyed said their votes as U.S. citizens do not count. Mm-hmm. What impact does that have?
Imagine that you have 55 million Hispanics. It's 18% of the population. By 2020, we will be 30 million voters, and they have no idea of their contributions. They don't feel valued, and absolutely, I think it comes to the point in which if the growth of America, the strength of the middle class, will come from the minorities, particularly Hispanics, and if they don't feel valued, if they don't know their power, and if they are fragmented, there is a potential danger, a red flag that we want to call on for tomorrow's leaders of the Hispanic Leadership Summit, say we have to do something. The young Hispanics have to be more optimistic than what they are getting now today.
Does that mean fewer people going to the polls? And if so, how do you address that going into 2020?
Precisely that, Elaine, you just hit the right button. Tomorrow, we're gathering 350 leaders from the Hispanic leaders that have been working on these countries, you know, like from representation of Hispanics to also corporate America that cares about that segment of society that is booming and growing. And all of us are going to be addressing one issue. The first one is, how do we unify the community? The number two is, how do we empower them? The main issue that we're finding, Elaine, is that Hispanics, 77% of Hispanics have no idea of their own contribution. And if you're not aware of your own contribution, of your own power, the problem of perception is not an external one. It's not that the media is or anyone else is talking to us about talking to Hispanics badly. It's just that we don't know our own power. And we will create the Vision 2020. That is precisely the goal of the Hispanic Leadership Summit, to come with the three goals and the three next steps that together we can do so that by 2020, we're not only aware of our own power and unified, but ready to express our voice in the ballots.
Well, the diversity really is tremendous within the Hispanic community, and part of that is generational. The survey also found that one in five who identify as second-generation Americans said they believed, quote, the American dream is alive and well. What factors, Claudia, do you think are driving this sentiment?
First-generation Americans like me coming to this country are still believing in the American dream and still believe that hard work and optimism will get you there. But the younger generations are less enthusiastic about that because they have not seen themselves represented, nor in media, nor in politics, not everywhere. Imagine that only 1% of Hispanics are politicians or represented. That goes to the same about like a corporate America or in the media. The main problem here is that we Hispanics are diversified group of origins, and that is actually putting us down. So instead of actually be thinking like, I'm Cuban, I'm Mexican, I'm Venezuelan, we have to bust those bubbles, and those 26 different origins should become one strong Hispanic community that has a voice together and can come and express it and demand the government and corporations to show us their love, not only with last-minute campaigns, all amigo campaigns, but just really investing in us, investing in our education, in our skilling, in the community service, in making sure that we can become that middle class of America that will help get the country higher.
Well, a lot of the survey does focus on the difference in opinions between first and second generation
Absolutely.
Americans. And I wonder what the big takeaways are, you think, between these two groups that make them so distinct from one another.
When you have people like me, first generation, coming to America, you still believe that the American dream is a possibility. When you have been here and you've seen your parents really give it all and kill themselves to have jobs and nevertheless feel that they are calling by hombres or that their voice doesn't matter or that the policies are not really going and reaching them, you start getting disillusioned. And that is a real danger for America. Young generations tend to be the optimist of every country. And if you have the most important minority of your country being disillusioned, thinking that there is no way that they will be ever seen or recognized or dignified, then they will actually start pulling down, expressing less voice, opening up less their wallets, and that is going to probably have an impact. So we have to address this issue. This is a serious red flag. I'm an absolute optimistic that Hispanics united are strong. But we have to address the issue right now.
So against that backdrop, the UN's first ever Hispanic Leadership Summit convenes on Monday. What are you hoping, Claudia, can actually be accomplished here by sharing the results of this survey with the participants?
Tomorrow, 350 people will have a voting device in their hands. Every one of them will use the best of their neutral platform and of this neutral platform by coming and identifying what are the three issues that together we can identify. Because this is the journey that we're going to go to. We've seen it in front of our eyes. We've seen, for example, the LGBT community being going from 5 years ago or something, being invisible, maybe shy about saying that you belong to a community because it could be detrimental to your career. And all of a sudden rallying forward one or two objectives like marriage, and all of a sudden seeing that transformation of all the LGBT is visible, proud of it, and probably it means that if you say that you're part of it, you will be promoted in your job better. So that's what I want to have seen in a couple of years for the Hispanic community, having those objectives, finding our marriage, what's our issue.
And so based on all of that and from your own experience as well, when you look at the results of this survey and you see a little bit of that pessimism and you think about that, what can be done today to try and change that, to try to make a difference?
Take a look at the mirror, Hispanics. It's time for Hispanics to talk about Hispanics, about the beauty of Hispanics. And we have to create a mirror, a pyramid of mirrors, so that everybody can see that. I want to see that number of 77% of Hispanics not being aware of their own power go down to 50%, to 30%, to zero. We can do that by really busting the bubble. And instead of thinking 26 different nations, try to unify in one, but it starts from within. There is a marketing problem, a perception problem within the community, and we shouldn't be talking about Hispanics to no one else but Hispanics. The time for Hispanics to be united and to be aware of their power is today, and we will see the transformation come really quickly.
All right. Claudia Romo Edelman, thank you so much, Claudia, for your time.
Thank you so much for having me here.